Hello everyone, this is Abdu Alkishe, a postdoctoral at fish and wildlife conservation at Virginia Tech. Today I'm going to explain the basic concepts in ecology. So what would you gain from this lecture is understanding the basic concepts, knowing different interaction between organisms, and in the end, I will explain a disease ecology very briefly. So first of all, what's ecology? So this field is interested in understanding the relationships between organisms and their environment. So there are two concepts here. The first one called biotic, or living factors that influence an ecosystem. So for example, here in redwoods, you can see some examples like insects, plants, mammals, reptiles, birds. Those are the biotic factors. The second one is abiotic, which is the non-living factors that influence an ecosystem. And in the example here in blue, words, you can see the air and sunlight, water as an examples of abiotic factors. So here in ecology, there are two concepts, producers, and this is like plants, bacteria, algae. So those organisms mainly use energy source for life on Earth, and also they called autotrophs. So they use light or chemical energy to create their food. The other one is consumers, and those consumers like us, we eat the producers, and those organisms use the energy and food from the producers. So for examples, as you see in the right picture, you see different type of consumers. For example, herbivores, so those organisms eat just plants. Omnivores, so like us, eat both plants and meat, animals. And carnivores only eat animals. And the new one is scavengers. So those are like eating bodies of dead organisms. So what are the ecological interactions between organisms? So we have competition and predation and also symbiosis. We are going to explain each one. So we start with the competition. This is typically between two species. For example, here we have the same species where there are like two kinds of carnivores fighting on the food. While here on the right picture, like a competition for a mating. Predation. So in this example, we use to say the strong eats the weak. The strongest eat the weakest. So in this example, you see the snake eats a frog, or the lion attacked a pool here. So this is a kind of predation. The symbiosis, it's the relationship between two species, and those two species live closely together. So under this interactions, there are a few other categories. First, mutualism. So those in this interaction, both species win, so they got benefit from each other. Commensalism. So this is that one kind of species get benefit, but there is no harm for the other one. For example, you see here the barnacles on the whale. So they got the benefit of the whale, but they don't harm the whale, and also the whale didn't get benefit from this interaction. The most important thing is the parasitism. So we are, as a disease ecologist, interested more in this relationship. And one organism live and get benefit from the other one and cause harm. So there is a win and lose in this interaction. And as you see, for example, here fleas on a dog. Also, another example, mosquitoes biting a human, or wasp put their eggs on a kind of caterpillar here in this example also. So the most important part now, and it's the a door for our next lectures, is the disease ecology. So in this picture on the right, you see different concepts like environments, pathogens, and hosts, and what's the relationship between the three concepts here is called the disease ecology, where we try to understanding the relationship between the pathogens, hosts, and their environments. And once we understand the disease ecology for a pathogen, so that will help us to put a plan to control, prevent, or to predict the emergence or re-emergence of diseases. And the concept of this field is starting with susceptibility, replicate, excrete, and then we have a maintenance host. And also after that, there is a spillover to the target host or spill back to the maintain host. And also there is an inter-species contract pattern. So for example, in this slide, so here there is an event called El Nino, which is, or Enzo here in this example, which is El Nino Southern Oscillation. And this is an event where a warming of the ocean surface or above average sea surface temperatures in the central and eastern tropical Pacific Ocean. So in this paper, the authors studied the effect of this event on the survival of a mouse here, and this species, and their circulation of the pathogen. For example, what they found is an extreme drought in the summer induced food storage is thought to be like increased mortality in mouse population. So this species relies on a food or on crop productive. And furthermore, in the winter temperature, they found that to exert complex effects on overwinter survival, thereby affecting the population growth rate in the following year. So understanding the environmental conditions how they affect the mice population can give us a sight on how the pathogen is circulating in that time. So in this field, there are some challenges to understand and some important research areas. For example, the challenge is developing and understanding the interaction among the pathogens, host, and their environmental. It's not easy to understand that. We have to understand the ecological and evolutionary aspects of infectious diseases. For the other side, for the research area, it's very important in terms of understanding the effects of environmental changes as selected agents on pathogen virulence and host resistance. And also, it's very important to developing a new approach to surveillance and monitoring to improve our theoretical models of host pathogen ecology. So it's very important field, and it's not easy. It has some complexity in terms of what kind of host pathogen system that you are studying, but this field is really important to answer a lot of the questions. In the end, thank you so much. And if you have any questions, my email is here. Thank you so much.